boy Super Mario 1990 coming at you with a Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League trailer reaction. This game's coming out next year, 2022. At least it's supposed to be. You never know with these video games. They be pushing stuff back. And COVID is actually affecting them too. Working from home and all these other conditions. You got crunch time already, of course, which has always been a thing. So you never really know. But it's supposed to be coming out 2022. And it's only going to be for next gen, so for PS5, Xbox One X / Series X, or backwards, I got that, I think. But that's what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be next gen only. And it was looking really good from what I saw last year. I like the concept. I like the idea. It's really funny. You actually get to play as the Suicide Squad. You get to play as Harley Quinn, one of my favorite characters of all time. You got Deadshot there. There's Sharky. A couple of other cats. I'm not really like too familiar with the Suicide Squad all like that. I saw the movie, the first reiteration of the movie. That was horrible, but I liked Margot Robbie in it so much. Will Smith was pretty funny. And Viola Davis always kills it as Amanda Waller. And I am familiar with Amanda Waller from Batman. So I already know what she about, how like dark and gritty she can get and how she be getting down. So it actually looks like a really fun game. I actually like the idea of playing with the Suicide Squad, especially Harley Quinn. So we just gonna check out this trailer. I remember last year's trailer looked really fun. So hopefully we get some gameplay this time around, because it was pretty much just giving you kind of like the intro to the characters that you're gonna be playing with, how they gonna be, how they gonna interact with each other, and basically just how the tone of the game is gonna be, which was like really silly, goofy, and fun. So let's check out this new trailer, and I will give y'all my thoughts and impressions afterwards. That's a good motivational speech.
You're good at what you do. Even if what you do is far from good.
Welcome to Death Force X. Alright. Well, take a look at you. Muscle head. Not chub. Something that offends my eyes. Don't do shark like that. Suicide mission. Hence Suicide Squad, I guess. Batmobile. Oh. Hey, get shot.
Raising hand and taking on the Justice League is the worst idea you've ever heard.
Hmm. My car designed that.
Ooh. Brainiac and them, that's a shit. Tick, 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 tick. That's your purpose. Ooh! See, it just blew off. Ooh, they ain't playing. Yeah, y'all ready for that line? Got the flash in this joint. Oh. Is that Robin?
Waller, the penguin is in flight. Repeat, the penguin is in flight.
Then let's clip his wings.
I could have caught him.
Boy, he's getting up.
Hitting him again.
They roll for that. Really? You do it too much. Okay.
Domino's is giving away 50.
I don't care what they're giving away. It's still looking really funny. Still looking really good. we actually get the hint of what's to come too, like with actual more like Justice League characters. Because I just really saw Batman from the first one, but it's Justice League, of course, it's gonna be everybody, right? So we saw Superman, we saw the Batmobile. I don't think I saw Batman. I think I saw Robin. I saw the Flash. I saw Green Lantern playing around with his ring, all this little crazy stuff he was doing. So it's looking really fun. It's looking like some real formidable. That's crazy. Your formidable enemies and opponents are good guys, but Brainiac ship too is you've seen like a clip where it's a Brainiac ship with all like the little tentacle in the arms and everything, and Brainiac is good with like controlling people's minds and stuff. So I'm thinking he's got like all the whole Justice League under their spell, and I guess in Suicide Squad is pretty much under Amanda Waller's spell with they, you know, collars around their neck, their heads can blow up and pop if they don't do what she say or don't fall in line like they supposed to. She got like that over their heads, well, around their necks, actually, you can say. But they forced to fight the Justice League, so it's looking really fun. I like the concept of it. It's really funny. I think it actually does come from a comic book, I think they say. I don't read comic books, so I'm not familiar with it, but really fun concept, really fun looking game. Like I said, man, you put Harley Quinn in something, and man, it's a wrap. It's already gonna be good. Deadshot, Sharky. It's kind of funny because I'm only familiar with Sharky. I don't think I recognized Sharky when I saw the last trailer. I remember the shark. Like, they got a whole shark, a talking shark in this game. That's crazy. And then I saw like the Harley Quinn cartoon show. I don't really know his origin or nothing like that, but I'm really just introduced to him from Harley Quinn and the trailer for these the two trailers for this game. But it's looking fun, still looking really funny. I like the storyline, I like the concept. It's gonna be a blast to play. We still didn't get gameplay, I don't think so, because it looks like it was all cutscenes, but the game does look really good, but supposed to be for next gen. But yeah, I mean, I can't wait to get my hands on it, play it. Rocksteady does nothing but good work when it comes to the DC license anyway. Everything I played from them was Batman related, and I've enjoyed all of them. I think I'll enjoy this one just as much, if probably not more so. I just like entertaining things, like just kick back, have some fun, laugh, be entertaining. It looks better than the Suicide Squad movies, or at least the first movie. I can't judge the second one because I haven't seen the second one. What is it, the second attempt? It's not a sequel, is it? I don't know. It's confusing. They had another go round with Suicide Squad. I didn't see the second round. I just saw the first go round. But this is looking better than those movies, honestly. But I ain't got a PS5. That's the only thing. I can't wait to get my hands on it. But it looks like one of them games where it's like, it don't seem like a day one to me for some reason. I think I just need to see actual gameplay. But I don't know, something about it is more like you wait for it to drop a little bit. At least for me anyway. You wait for it to drop maybe $20-$30. Especially if they're going to charge $70. Like, that price point is crazy to me. Like I said, I'm still on last gen, so I ain't got to worry about no whole $70 price tag. But I'm pretty sure I'm going to be annoyed when I do get me a PS5 and be like, $70 day one? I might have to wait, bro. I don't know what y'all talking about. But yeah, man, this is Super Mario 1990. Let me know if y'all feeling this game, who y'all favorite Suicide Squad character is. As you can see, mine is Harley Quinn. I'm all about Harley. And so, yeah, I can't wait to play this game. Are y'all feeling this game? Do y'all want to see some gameplay? How y'all feeling about it? I'm feeling good. I'm feeling like it's going to be an entertaining game, nonetheless. It's going to be fun. You're going to have some laughs. You're going to have a blast. Rated M, you already know they're going to be bringing it. It's going to be violent. It's going to be chaotic. It's going to be funny. It's going to be crazy, over the top. You know, like, yeah, it's going to be good. This is Super Mario 1990, and I'm out. Peace and.